Israel is being accused of stoking the flames of an all-out regional war in the Middle East. Two attacks in 2 days have seen more deaths across Lebanon, this time exploding walkie-talkies, with Turkey's foreign minister warning Hezbollah and Iran have no choice but to respond.
They had gathered to mourn victims of the first explosions when a second wave hit. The shock blasts triggered mass terror. There was confusion in the crowd, then the realization Israel had struck again. Across Lebanon, more synchronized explosions. Fire and smoke filled the air as walkie-talkies used by Hezbollah militants blew up. There are also reports solar energy systems detonated in several homes. At least 20 people were killed and hundreds more injured. Hospitals cannot cope, already overwhelmed after pocket-sized pagers exploded yesterday.
I think what happened is a slap in the face of whoever is in the region who wants to find a diplomatic solution.
Israel now claims a new phase of the war is beginning, moving more troops to the border with Lebanon. Benjamin Netanyahu's aim is clear: to return residents of the north to their homes safely. Rocket and drone attacks from Hezbollah have displaced thousands of Israelis. The central question now is where the war goes from here. Are these attacks an isolated episode or the prelude to a much bigger offensive?
The Lebanese government does not want war. We have been for a year now heavily mobilized to try to avoid what we're seeing today.
This is the closest that I think we've been to a regional war since 1973.
As for whether Lebanon bombings leave Gaza ceasefire negotiations and the fate of the hostages,
I can't tell you in this moment what impact this will have.
John Paul Gonzo for 10 News First.